In this video, we're going to discuss how actions and triggers connect to one another in order to make experimental events occur in the proper manner, and how messages can be used to mark the occurrence of these experimental events in the iLink data file. The Posner task example begins with a perfect illustration of the basics of Experiment Builder connections. The first display screen action, which has been renamed to display camera setup instructions by changing its label property, presents some simple camera setup and calibration instructions to the display PC monitor. To see and edit the contents of a display screen action, simply double click on it to bring up the screen builder for that display screen action. From here, you can add images, videos, text, shapes, and interest areas to build up the display screen action's content. This particular display screen action uses a multi-line text resource to present the instructions. Display screen actions need to be followed by at least one trigger before connecting to other actions that change the contents of the display PC monitor. Otherwise, the contents of that display screen action will be immediately replaced by the drawing of the next display screen action. The triggers keep the experiment from moving on automatically immediately. This particular display screen action connects to the subsequent camera setup action via a keyboard trigger and a timer trigger. These connections will make it so that either a key press that causes the keyboard trigger to fire, or the passage of enough time that causes the timer trigger to fire, must occur before the experiment proceeds. Both of these triggers connect to the same camera setup action, so whichever one fires first will take the experimental flow onto that camera setup action. One of the most important aspects of action and trigger nodes in Experiment Builder is the message property. When an action occurs or a trigger fires, the contents of the message property are sent to the host PC and inserted into the iLink data file with a timestamp. These messages in the iLink data file thus mark the occurrence of experimental events. For display screen actions, these messages are time-locked to the start of the particular screen retrace and will be written to the data file with a timestamp marking the time of occurrence. The timestamp will be within a millisecond of the associated retrace event. It is critical to make sure that you are filling out the message property of your action and trigger nodes so that you have a record of the timing of your experimental events in the EDF file. These messages can be used in data analysis to set what we call interest periods. Setting an interest period allows you to include only a particular part of your experimental trials in your analysis. For example, when we analyze the data from this Posner task project, we will likely want to focus on the period of time in the trial from the onset of the target until a response is made, and exclude the fixation, cue, SOA, and feedback periods of the trial. We can use the messages associated with the actions and triggers to set the interest period accordingly in DataViewer. You can find a discussion of interest periods in our Data Viewer video tutorial series. For now, it's just a good idea to remember the importance of using the message property to mark the time when important experimental events occurred. Note, the label property of nodes can be changed too, but a change in the label property only changes what it is called in the Experiment Builder user interface. The message property specifies the text that will be sent to the EDF file to mark the occurrence of the experimental event associated with the node. This example was created by giving each node meaningful labels and then copying and pasting the label text into the message property. That way, it's really easy to associate messages in the EDF file with particular nodes in the Experiment Builder project when looking at the data file during analysis.